So my name is Gordon Smith. I'm a postdoc in the David Fitzpatrick Lab at the Max Planck Florida Institute for Neuroscience. We study how experience shapes the development of the visual system and how the visual system uses that experience to be able to process information most efficiently. We use microscopes to look at the functions of individual brain cells and how those brain cells communicate with each other and how those brain cells respond to sensory stimuli. So working in a lab is, I think, it's really fun. Every day is a different set of challenges. Every experiment is slightly different. You're learning things that you sometimes are completely unexpected and can really change the way you think about things. I was born in Bloomington, Indiana. I always was interested in figuring out how things worked and in taking things apart. So, you know, as a kid, I would, you know, find old computers or printers and rip them apart and try to figure things out. I think I was drawn to science with the sort of the idea that there are a lot of unanswered questions and the ability to both take systems apart, understand how systems work, and to potentially learn things that we don't know at all. As a high school student, I worked in a lab, a neuroscience lab at the university in the town where I grew up. I think those experiments were, you know, enough to sort of get me excited about the science and to sort of see the people in the lab doing experiments and thinking about, I think, really interesting problems and trying to figure out how things worked. And I really sort of was drawn to that. The systems that we're studying are complicated, the brain is complicated, the experiments we're trying to do are complicated, and a lot of the time things don't work or they don't give you an answer that's clear. And that can be very frustrating. The best thing when that happens is to sort of keep going, and it can be really the sort of reward at the end when you finally break through or sort of figure out a way around the problem you're having is really quite wonderful. The fact that we don't understand how the system works makes it that much harder to figure out what's wrong in a disease. So by understanding how the brain works and how the brain develops in a normal case, I think it will still have lasting impact for our ability to treat diseases.
We're trying to figure out whether the beam is flat and whether we can actually get the beam straight through, whether it's at an angle, whether the LEDs are aligned or not. Mm-hmm. And then we can do that, we can repeat that for the two photon laser.
The brain is very complicated, so we need to understand it on a variety of levels. So we need to understand all the way down to the levels of molecules and genes, all the way up to behaviors. And being able to put all those different levels of understanding together is what's ultimately going to allow us to really understand the brain and really be able to apply therapies to disease states. Working in a lab and actually doing science it has its ups and downs. It has its moments of failure where things don't work, and it has its moments of great success where, you know, things suddenly click and you really understand something. If you're interested at all, try it. Try to get into a lab and check it out, because, you know, when it works, it's incredibly rewarding. It can be amazingly exciting and really cool.